and open to try new things. I started to actually see myself as an artist, and the more I created art and saw it valued by others, the more I enjoyed it. And that my use of line and color and shapes and being able to express myself and teach others to freely express themselves was the greatest thing about art. I do art that represents my culture, that represents experiences I've had. I do art that represents the time, what's going on in the time. I'm a retired educator, so I was an art teacher and a principal. So I retired in Anchorage, Alaska, when I was working so hard I never had time to do art. And ironically, I was teaching art and never had time to make it. I was always an activist when it came to advocating for the arts. And that's how I ended up in administration in Anchorage. That every time they tried to cut the art budget, I was the one speaking before the school board. And before long, I was applying for a principal position. And they thought, but you're an art teacher. But by the time I got through presenting why I thought I'd be a wonderful principal, I got the job. And so in those 20 years that I was in Alaska, I was able to study many, many different cultures. But the more I learned about different cultures and learned more about the art as I taught, I realized that the fact that art is the ultimate means of expression. When I was an educator, I used art to keep the at-risk students in school. And that's what I felt it did for me in high school, is when I really discovered I love doing art. This is what I want to do the rest of my life. And I had a mother who said, you're going to college. And I said, okay, if I can go for art. So her deal was, it's got to be art education. Because after retiring from education, I'm really enjoying my art even more. A lot of my art has patterns and rhythmic patterns that remind you of African art. Because I really love doing patterns and bold colors, and I'm an abstract artist pretty much. My favorite medium is acrylic painting. Sometimes I'll paint something, and I'll paint something, and then I'll walk away from it sometimes a day or two, and then I'll come back to it, and I kind of let it speak to me what else I need to do to it. Very seldom do I paint something like in a day or two. Sometimes it's weeks, just because I kind of let it develop. I had been approached years earlier about doing some of my art on textiles, and so now I have a whole line of clothing from my wearable art work, and they said your patterns and your use of color and design would really look beautiful on fabric. Have you ever thought about it? Well, the light bulb went off. I went to East Carolina School of the Art for art education with a concentration in textiles. I never had used the textiles part, I hadn't even thought about it. And when they said that, I thought, well, that's why my work looks like it would work wonderful on fabric. I don't do the art just for the fabric. I still do my art. And then I go back and look at it and see if there's something in that artwork that I could capture a pattern that works good and repeats on fabric. I think the first artist that I was really, really admired was Faith Ringel, who was a quilt artist and collage. And during the time I was in art school, she was working to get her work in the Whitney. And not only did she have to battle the fact that she was an African-American artist trying to get into the museums, they would invite African-American artists in, but not women artists. And she began to tell her stories through her quilts and her collages, and I just loved anything she does. I love it when I stand back and hear people talk about the rich, bold color. I know my art's not for everybody because my colors are not very muted. I use bold colors. But sometimes that's a pleasant surprise for people. They like that. I have done landscapes and things like that, and people seem to like those too, but that's just not where my heart is. Crying, and it's called Mother's Tears of Injustice. And that one was done this summer. Adinkra, African symbols across the bottom, and in her clothing that stand for unity and faith. Greek organizations from college. All of those, there's colors in there from all nine groups. I'm Alpha Kappa Alpha, which is pink and green, which you can kind of tell since the ladies wearing pink and green. So those are a strong bond in the African-American community, and they pull together in unity. The mask, of course, is of 2020, COVID. But as I was painting that, I was having a tough day, and I usually never paint eyes. You'll see in a lot of my paintings, I've just recently started to put open eyes. I just never did open eyes. This time I had no problem painting her eyes, and then I just want tears. Tears are coming out of her eyes. What's happened here recently has just had a profound effect on me. And artists, that's what we do. You know, we express the times and what we're feeling and what's happening in the times. This one's called She Can. And it's a woman's face kind of lost in the confusion of life, but she's boldly peeking through. And the first thing I would say is to study your art and yourself and find what it is that you love to do. What is your favorite type of art to make, or what makes you feel you express yourself best? And then do a lot of it and study about people that do it. The more that you study about other artists and just surround yourself with art. I love just going to art museums. That's my favorite thing to do, is just go out to the museum and walk by myself and just spend a day at the museum. I've been to the Louvre. I've been to the LA Museum and spent days there. I just love to surround myself with the art. When I was in Alaska, the Alaska Native art, I just really learn as much as you can about it and then do a lot of it and never give up. Just continue to have your art out there. It's easier than ever now with virtual learning and putting your art out in as many avenues as you can, and don't give up. Don't give up. So that's my hope, to continue to share my art, to help others express themselves and share their love for art. Even if they can't make art, they can wear art. So